Hello students, today I am going to take lecture of Advanced Java Unit 7 Spring MVC, and in this video I am going to explain you bean life cycle. So starting with introduction of bean, differentiating Java bean versus basic Java class. We have studied Java, and as you all know that bean is a Java class itself, but it differentiates some of its property from basic Java class. So let us understand it. A bean is a Java class, but a Java class does not have to be a bean. Second point, a Java bean is a Java class that should have following convention. The first convention is it should have a default constructor. It means it should have at least one no argument constructor. Second, it should be serializable, means it should be thread safe. Third point, it should provide method to set and get the values of its properties, which is also known as a getter and setter method. For example, a Pojo class. Why to use Java Bean? It is a reusable software component, so it can be reused. Second point, a bean encapsulates many objects into one object, so we can access this object from multiple places. Third point, it provides easy maintenance as it is an MVC architecture, so maintenance is comparatively easier. Now Java Bean architecture. So a request comes from a client browser. It is forwarded to JSP page or any other view page. That request is forwarded to Java Bean. Now Java Bean, if required, will communicate to enterprise information system, process the request, get the response back, give it back to JSP page by creating UI component, and then response is given back to original client. So this is a Java Bean architecture. Now Bean lifecycle, most important part of Java Bean. The life cycle of Spring Bean is easy to understand. If you are familiar with servlet and JSP life cycle, it is damn easier to understand life cycle of Java Bean. First, when the bean is instantiated, the Java Bean is instantiated within container. It may be required to perform some initialization to get it into usable state. Second point. Similarly, when the bean is no longer required, it is removed and available to garbage collector from container. Some cleanup may be required. So let us check diagram of bean life cycle. Bean initialized within containers. Bean activation. So whatever activity, setting, setter method, getter method, setting the attribute, getting the attribute, etc. So processing of request is known as bean activation. For example, bean will communicate with database either to retrieve the data from the database or to insert data to database. These are some of the examples. And last stage, bean shutdown, that is bean destruction, and container will make this bean available for garbage collector then. So starting with bean initialization, then bean activation, and then bean destruction. Let us check one example of bean lifecycle. Public class hello world bean, some string with name message, then init, this is initialization, bean is going to init, then getter and setter method, and destroy. So this is bean lifecycle program. Student, if this question is being asked in exam, you need to draw lifecycle of bean. You need to explain all the three stages, and additionally you need to explain it with the help of one simple example of bean life cycle. With this, I complete bean life cycle. Thank you all of you.